And the law will be taking the minutes as usual. And the date is the 15th of February, 1986. Before we begin, housekeeping. In the case of a fire, please slowly and calmly make your way to the lit fire exits. Look at them now. Yep, that's right.
What is this I hear? Ren gets to leave office?
That's right. I'm sick of you fools. I'm leaving you all for the wide open spaces. Oh, what? Really?
See? I told you he was moving.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. The wide open spaces? Where's that? Bolo, baby.
Oh, that's probably some big time anybody's heard of.
Calm down now. People have heard of it.
Oh, yeah? Well, what's the name of it then?
You just can't find it on any map.
What's the name of it?
Man, folks are flocking. They're from all over.
What's the name of it?
Ooh. Huntley.
Huntley? Huntley? Where the...
Hallelujah.
Is it Huntley?
Thank you. away from the big city of Oakland, Ethel and her son, Ron.
It's Ren.
Huh? Speak up, boy.
It's Ren.
Yeah, that's what I said. Ron. Anyways, I'm sure that we'll make you feel very welcome. Backward if you ask me.
Ren, don't stop. I don't want to move into Monday either.
Then let's go home.
Ren, I do wish your father had left us. That things could still be how they were. But...
Yeah, okay. I'm sorry.
And we both wish I can be one of those modern 1980s women that don't need no man. I can strut around in a pantsuit being self-sufficient. But I'm not.
Well, Mrs. McCormick, your sister certainly has been excited about you moving in with him.
Lulu and Wes have always been my rock. And you too, Leslie.
And we are certainly looking forward to becoming an integral and devoted part of the Huntley community.
Thank you, Rupert.
And when will Mr. McCormack be joining us?
Mr. McCormack won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
Yeah, he went like this and just went.
Rin, please, darling.
Ethel, I made the vanilla cookies in the shape of iconic Huntley buildings. There's the Huntley Power Plant, and there's the very old church! Look, you can see Rupert Shaw through the window. Yoo-hoo! Yoo-hoo!
That is lovely. Eleanor, shall we go make some tea to go with these cookies?
So, Rick, what's it for school tomorrow?
Oh, we took care of it last week. Coach helped him get registered.
So then, Reverend, did you hear about that new young English teacher who was planning on bringing some very vulgar tips into our new curriculum?
Oh, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory? Yes, Coach, I've heard. I've received several calls.
Yeah, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. That book's so great, man. My mom used to read it to me as a kid.
Young man, are you a fool? A book that promotes greed and indulgence.
Man, you gotta be joking with me, Rev. That book's a classic. At my old school, we had to study The Silence of the Lambs.
Do you read? Do you read? Well, you might want to consider what you read in the future.
Dad, Rusty and the girls are going off to Rivers tonight. Can I go?
Tomorrow's a school day, Ariel.
I know that.
Ask your mother.
We already did, Reverend Moore. She said it was okay with her. If it was okay with you. So is it okay with you, Reverend Moore?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock.
Oh, a great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
What you said about dancing being the creation of the devil, I mean, who knew? Oh, no more dancing for me.
High praise indeed, Rusty. 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock.
Well, howdy there, my ladies.
Your dad lets you wear that?
No way! Well, my dad barely even notices me nowadays anyways, so that's alright.
Oh my gosh! He's cute! When you tell me he's cute! Oh my gosh! Yes!
He sure is cute!
He's the cutest!
The cutest I ever saw! But I bet he knows he's cute.
Which makes him less cute. What do you think? He's the cutest! Oh, my feet! Watch your tongue! Watch your tongue back into your mouth! And let's get out of here!
Ciao, fellas!
Where do you think you're going?
Where do you think? Ooh. And if anyone asks, I was with you all evening, right?
Ariel?
Yup.
Okay!
Speak up!
What's cooking, good looking? Did you miss me?
You wish. Oh, Cheetah, Biffle, Gavin, Bruza, Scarface. Oh no, did I interrupt your weekly poetry reading?
That's probably been read anyway.
So, who are that new guy in church?
Who? Oh, him! He's our new classmate! An open outcast who comes with all the charms and sophistications of living in a bustling metropolis.
Well, shall I be jealous of this guy?
I'm counting on it.
Whoa! You better slow it down, Ariel.
Touch my knees.
The way you cruise around this town, being the preacher's daughter and all.
No way. Me and God, we got a good thing going. I like to think of her as a friend.
Ariel, you call God a she? That's blasphemy, Ariel.
Don't you and your girls keep your reputation instead? It's soiled already. Yeah.
Only because I hang out with the likes of you lot.
You better watch it, Ariel. A girl like you should keep herself pure and take it.
Yeah, you're the preacher's daughter, for God's sake.
Shh, quiet.
You're the preacher's daughter, for goodness sake.
Okay, we're dead.
I'm sick of this town. If they can't handle me or my girls, they can stick it.
Whoa. You better watch it, Chuck. Look up, it's a ball, Chuck. Just the way I like it, man. Let us go, bro. Come on, go.
You said you would be, and your friend suggested that you might be here.
We are just on our way there.
Your mother thought you might be cold.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
Proverbs 12:22. The Lord detests lying lips, but he delights in people who are trustworthy.
I know, Dad. I'm sorry.
Come on. School in the morning.
I'm Ren. Ren McCormack. We met yesterday after church.
Oh, hey, big city boy! What's it like mingling with the country folk?
So. Hey, Ariel, leave that poor boy alone.
Yes.
said I'm sorry.
Did you ever watch where you're going?
Apparently not.
Hey, it's that guy from Auckland. Nah, listen, dogs, around here you push someone, you get pushed back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing you.
Jeez. Yeah, nah. Do you play rugby?
Ha! What was that? Some kind of stupid Auckland joke?
Man, I'm just trying to get the lay of the land.
Oh, yo.
Are you in the first 15?
Obviously. Look at me. How about you? What do you do?
Nothing. I just dance, eh?
Oh.
Get up, please.
Man, Ren, he's very sorry. He was ignorant of our local law. And I will teach him. I will teach him.
And I will see him at my office after school. Now, don't you have places to be? Wallen! Why are you just in principal class? It was like the longest sentence I've ever heard you say.
Oh!
That's super hot. Seeing a man fly in the face of authority.
Hey, chin up, Mr. McCormack.
Man, was she serious?
As serious as a hat, Tim.
Dancing's against the law.
Has been for 5.5 years.
Ever since the accident. The Huntley Bridge accident.
Sorry, but what?
You've never heard of the
Huntley Bridge accident?
I will take this one, ladies. Now, there are these four kids we all grew up with. One night, they're coming back from a dance party in Pocono.
Do you know the place that is famous for its bacon and...
Oh, you got it. Maybe it was the rain that night. Or maybe they're being a little bit wild. But somehow, they lost control of the car. It skidded across the bridge, crashed into the railing, and fell 35 feet into the Huntley Bridge water.
Did anyone survive?
No. Oh, yeah. They want to please release the autopsy report. They claim there was alcohol and marijuana in their blood. Well, that day, Cloud came over the town. And that's when Rivermore changed forever. He started blaming anything and everything on drugs, drinking, and dogs.
Dancing. And how could anyone possibly blame dancing?
He convinced the town council that dancing was a sin. And just like that, he passed this law.
Rivermore has a type of power.
Rivermore? He is the power.
He is the law.
And how can your stance look like this?
Practice, baby. Years of practice.
The city of Auckland, Ren. This has been so cool to live in a big city. No rules, no curfews. Totally free.
Yeah. But like, I thought living in a small town would be alright. Like in the movies. What, when they're like one good happy family?
Oh, it is. One very close family.
Where everyone knows your every move. Tongues are wagging at everything you do.
Fingers pointing the minute you turn around. Head shaking the minute you cross the line.
Are you ready?
first.
You're gonna regret it. Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
Oh, he nearly ripped my shirt.
That's a lie. Hey, boys, you're watching.
Yeah. Hey, that's enough. I won't have some silly kid coming in and disturbing my class.
Silly kid? He started it.
That is enough of you, Mr. McCormick. This is the third time in as many weeks that you have caused disruption. Detention for a week.
A week?
A month.
How hard it was for me to get you that job at Dilligan's hardware store? Huh? It's not even a month that you got fired.
Every day is bad news with you, Ren. Every day.
Lily, did I exaggerate?
Hush, Ethel! You're not helping.
Ren, tell us your big
reasons. I'm not thinking I should be fired for. Willie came by the shop to get some change, so I popped open the register. And when Mr. Dillingham came down, he saw my hand in the drawer and went crazy. He thought I was stealing.
That is because everything that you do makes people suspicious.
Suspicious! You are a guest in my home and I won't tolerate thieving.
Wes, he said he didn't do it.
I know, Ethel, but look at him! He's clearly going wild.
It's alright, I'm done.
Ethel, don't encourage his behavior.
Come on, what, a few more minutes?
My dad is already very weary of me seeing you.
So? Just tell him to get used to it.
You tell him.
If she said it, hey, Reverend Moore, I'm dating your daughter. Hey, quit her! What?
I'm not in the mood for one of the sermons. Go home now, Chuck. No, oh, please. Hi, Dad. Hi, Mom.
Are you hungry?
Starving, thanks. Oh, what's this, Dad? Haydn. The second sonata.
The fourth.
Oh, number four. That's right. I guess this kind of music's still good by you, eh, Dad?
Me?
She was joking.
I'm aware of that vibe. This kind of music is uplifting. It doesn't confuse the mind or promote your thought.
Are you working on a sermon?
I am.
Do you remember when I was younger and I used to sit in the pews and you would practice over and over again?
I do indeed.
And when you were done, I would clap and cheer and you would bow, remember?
Yes, well, you certainly have earned that behavior.
What's that supposed to mean?
Sometimes, I wish you were still a child.
Dad?
Sweetie, your father's had a difficult day today.
I can speak for myself.
Honey, why don't you sit the table?
It's alright. I'm not hungry anymore.
Sure, if you are angry with Ariel, then please tell her why.
I'm not angry, I'm concerned.
Then talk to her. You two talk and nothing gets said.
Have you seen her with this Chuck Press?
Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not a delinquent.
He most certainly was.
This is not a funny vibe.
I was just trying to lighten the mood.
Well, I'm concerned for our daughter.
So am I, but you can't expect her to stay here at home with us.
Let's just stop this conversation.
Conversation. It feels more like I've walked in one of your sermons.
Please, boy. Let's not say anything that we might regret.
To smile with a choking, learning to be silent.
Mama says it's in my nature. Look, dogs. Ariel, she likes trouble. And you've already proven to everyone in this town that you're trouble.
Come on, I was only teasing him.
That was way more than teasing. Ren's from out of town. He's not used to your sense of humor yet.
You got out of Huntley so bad, I bet you memorized the bus schedule. You told us that you read to Escapes of the Worlds.
I do. In books, I get to meet guys who are amazing.
What about Ren?
What about him? He's sort of cute, and tall, and smart. And so?
What's the deal with you and Rusty?
I don't know. Like, I like her and all, but honest to gosh, not gonna lie. To be honest, she talks more than any other girl I've ever met in my life.
To be honest, I think she just likes you. Man, every time you walk in that room, she changes.
Is that what you think?
If only I could find a guy like the one I heard about in this book report.
If only I could find a guy that when he kisses me goodnight, he'll just take the toothpick out of his mouth.
Oh my gosh, Chuck's gonna lose it.
Move, Rue! Get on my wing!
Ariel, what the hell is going on? You had a date half an hour ago. I've been waiting.
I know, Chuck. I'm sorry.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
And why would you? You already do such a good job for yourself.
Stop putting on your door! No one has taken too much time.
Hey, Chuck. Are you joining the ladies for dinner?
Can you get out of my way, city kid? But when I say meet me at 8, I mean meet me at 8, Ariel.
Okay, Chuck, just calm down.
Hey, hey! If you're going, don't tell me to calm down. Don't you ever tell me what to do. I've had enough. Let's go.
No.
I said let's go, Ariel.
No.
Excuse me?
I'm not telling you five for normal. I said no!
Just wait. Wait till we get home. Yeah.
No.
Hey.
Sorry, but I believe she said no.
Sorry, but I believe this is none of your business. Can you get your hand out of my face? And get your face out of my sight? Aha, is that a fight you want? What are you doing, you first beard thing you wanna be? Huh? 5, 3, 2, 1. Wow.
Just discussing the health and safety of one of our customers.
You think this is funny?
Preston, your truck's outside parked in yellow lights. Now if you don't move it, you bet your crusty ass looking ass that I will move it myself.
Just wait! First 15 wannabe! You didn't make the team! I did make... you know what, come! No, ma'am. Well, can I kick him? No?
Lilith, we'll say your mum always says, eh? Before you make your fist, make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am, I get so fired up, I just wanna dance.
I'm gonna just pretend I didn't see that either. Now you're all about to be going home.
Bye, Rin.
Oh, you too, Rin. Your shift is over.
Yes, ma'am. I am in my apron.
Listen to me here. I will see you here same time tomorrow.
So I'm not fired?
Not yet. Now get lost. I have somewhere to be.
Now you, Rin McCormack, are either very brave or very stupid.
And which do you think it is?
I haven't made up my mind yet. But Chuck, he's like every other guy I know. Good at holding grudges. Hey, you wanna see something?
Didn't you have a curfew?
Ren, rules aren't made to be broken. Come on.
Something here.
Like what?
The minister's daughter, Chuck Cranston's girlfriend, and? Nice boots, mate.
Oh, my dad hates these boots.
Yeah, and you just love to disobey him, don't you?
No, I just like to shake him up a bit. That way, he'll miss me when I'm gone.
And where do you plan on going?
Uni for starters. I want to speak 5 different languages and see the whole world. Well, my dad wants me to take after him and be a teacher.
A teacher? You? Yeah, I can't see it.
Yeah, neither can I. So I'll just leave it to dad.
But your dad's a preacher, not a teacher.
Well, when you're good at it, it's kind of the same thing. And my dad used to be real good at it.
What changed?
His mind. He closed it.
I knew this.
He used to be so inspiring, so hopeful. He could bring hope when hope was lost. Ren? What happened to your dad?
He just walked out one day. He walked out and never came back.
Wow. I bet there's lots you'd like to say to him.
Yep. Lots.
I know. Say it to the train.
Are you stupid?
Anyways, follow me.
And I can't seem to hold one in my own.
Well, you know that saying, though, sir. It's always the shoemaker's children going barefoot.
Oh! Would you look at the time?
It sure can clear a room.
A rare talent.
I'll try to take that as a compliment, sir.
Well, I assure you. It wasn't meant as one.
Believe this arrow belongs to you.
Thanks for walking me home, Ren.
Well, how? Hi, Mrs. Ma.
Hi, Ren.
I blew it in there, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
And I just get so much energy, chakra, just a vibe. I always end up putting my foot in my mouth.
Your mother did say that. Now I've seen her firsthand, but you'll be okay, Ren. Good night.
No, Mrs. Wong.
I don't want you to see him.
Who? Ren? Just because he hasn't lived in this town his whole life.
That is not it. Clearly the boy has no respect for authority. And I've heard he is a troublemaker.
Who did you hear this from? Your little Monopoly club. Give me a break.
Aaron.
What's wrong with you, Dad? Lately all you do is see the worst in people.
Aaron, where did this come from?
Your sermon today. The world is pure and evil, so Ariel should be locked up in a tower.
That is a little bit overdramatic, Ariel. Don't you think?
No, Dad. It's not dramatic. I'm still living in this prison.
Well, someone has to put their foot down.
I don't even say anything.
Thank you.
and look at his hand, it's all bent up.
No, it's alright. I just drove into a...
Oh, enough with your lame excuses, Ren.
But it's not an excuse, Coach. After Ren walked me home last night, some guys jumped him.
Yo, they thought it was real bad.
From this guy. I've been asked to keep my eye on you.
My father called you. Of course he did.
Wait, Reverend Shaw called you to keep Ariel away from me? Man, if my dad called, would you get off my back?
Mr. McCormick, that mouth of yours is probably what made your daddy run off in the first place.
Gee, just count to 10. That's what my mom says, just count to 10.
You'd be wise to take your friend's advice. In fact, while you're doing all that counting, you can give me 10 push-ups too.
Man, you've got to be kidding me.
You're right, give me 50. In fact, because of Mr. McCormick, you can all give me 50 push-ups.
Yeah, good, that's enough. Yeah. Now, what, I think I'm done with this back in town. And I've been thinking, maybe everyone's so crazy because y'all never get to loosen up. You know?
I don't know. What are you plotting, Ren?
I'm plotting something real good, Willard. Are you ready to shake what your mama gave you? Are you ready to show me your tail feathers? My bro, are you ready to?
I don't know what you're saying!
Man, a dance, Willard! Oh. I'm gonna organize a full blown, old fashioned dance! And no one can stop me!
I think he's officially lost it! Dancing is a crime, Ren! Legal?
Dead!
Legal?
I don't care! Man, of course I'm serious. As serious as I've ever been. Come to these parts of town.
I wouldn't be so sure about that, Brent.
Why, hi there.
Hi, Biddy. I mean, Mrs. Biddy, Sir Biddy, Lord Biddy, Sergeant Biddy, Princess of Mama!
Now calm yourself down, Ernie. I ain't gonna tell your mama.
You're not, Biddy?
No,
it's me. But why not?
If I tell your mama that I was at the Rebellion dance joint after hours on a Friday, then I gotta explain to your mama that I was at the Rebellion dance joint after hours on a Friday. You picking up what I'm putting down?
No. Please, it's hard enough, Biddy!
It's okay, sweetheart. Just stay low and keep yourself out of trouble. You hear me, Willie Lip?
Yes, ma'am.
See, what could hardly possibly happen against Darcy?
Yeah! Who could have guessed that this can happen less than 100 kilometers outside of Huntley?
And be this much fun!
Come on, then. Stay back alone.
Hello? Oh, I gotta go!
Shake your tail, fellas.
That makes her the preacher's daughter?
Sure does.
Well, blow me down with a feather. Her daddy and I were close back in the day. Real close.
Ew!
Tell me, what is it like being young girls of your age and not being able to do well anything fun?
It sure has its drawbacks, man.
It sure does.
At the end of the day, us girls, we just want the same thing.
Why, guess you mean? You're all right about that.
Thank you. cowboy?
Oh yeah? Well, we all make mistakes.
What's that supposed to mean?
I was just joking, Willem.
Oh, okay.
And in case you didn't notice, Chompy, that's the 80s, and women are allowed to make their own decisions.
Who are you calling Chompy? You Chompy?
Look, it's too early in the evening to put on a pretty little shirt of yours.
He's running.
Well, Willard, this is it. What a moment! I'm gonna remember this moment for the rest of our lives, where we stare into each other's eyes and dance together!
Ah! I gotta go pee.
Rusty, is Willard acting weird again?
So it's not just me?
No offense, Rusty, but you and Willard have been acting weird since kindergarten.
But this is our first night out of Huntley. It's an iconic night for us.
And it's okay, Rusty. I'll dance with you.
So now, decide it. Look how bad Chompy there, mate.
Gee, Dano. I'm confused.
About?
I don't know how to tell her.
Tell her what?
That I can't do it.
You can't do it?
Yeah, I can't do it.
That's alright, Doc. Because I watched TV yesterday, and on the news, it said that relationships last longer if you don't do it on the first date. You know, some people, they wait till marriage.
Huh? No dancing until marriage?
Yeah. Dancing. Dance. Yeah. You can't dance? Well, look here, you can't dance.
Gee, I can't do it. I can't dance. I can. Yeah, I can't.
Oh dear darling. Your boyfriend had 2 feet and you had no idea?
Well, no. How could I? We weren't allowed to dance.
So how do you know we like to do? Does he sweep you off your feet every chance he gets?
No.
Does he hold you close and never let you go?
Well, no.
Does he whisper sweet nothings in your ear?
No, that's not it.
Well,
it's not like that with me and Willard, man. Willard has a lot of hidden talents. I mean, just look at him.
You were saying?
Thank you.
It's just you, Mrs. Moore.
Did I scare you?
Scared? No way!
No!
Anyways, did you tell Ariel?
Yes, Chuck, I have told her the many times you have called.
I guess she's just busy then.
Yeah, her and the girls went over to Wendy Jo's to study.
Wendy Jo's to study?
Yeah.
That's what Ariel told you. But I just came back from Wendy Jo's. Wendy Jo's mom just said that they're all gone out together.
Who is the boy? Oh, Mr. Crest.
Oh, Reverend.
Isn't that a bit late, Mr. Craster?
Of course. That's why I'm a bit surprised Ariel isn't home. Aren't you?
Good night, Chuck.
Good night, Reverend.
Well, what is your explanation for this behavior?
I'm not going to say anything until I hear her side of the story.
This has got to stop, boy. It was bad enough for hanging around with the likes of Chuck Craster. But now, she's out of all hours of the night with that punk who's campaigning to challenge me and the whole town council. Where were you?
Rusty and Wendy Jo's.
Don't even bother, everyone.
We know you weren't at Wendy Jo's.
I can't believe you guys are checking up on me.
Sweetie, how are we to know if you're hurt or sick?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Really? Then how come when I'm home you don't listen to a word that I say? You look down on me like you're ashamed.
Ariel, that is enough.
No, Dad, because you are ashamed of me, and I'm getting really tired, Dad. I'm tired, Dad. You keep comparing me to Bobby, but when will you realize that Bobby's gone? He's dead!
Ariel! We're losing her, boy. She's becoming stubborn and obstinate.
Funny that. She's just like her father.
Why? I don't know what to do.
Yes, you do, my love. Can you stop and see if there's part of her that's trying to obey, while a part of her is trying to run away? Can't you hear what she's trying to say? Can you find before.
All I'm saying is that if you are going to talk in front of the town council, you got to speak more loud and clear. Do it again.
Ladies and gentlemen of the Huntley Town Council, I am Ren McCormack, and I believe dancing is not a crime.
Stubborn people in this town.
Yeah, you have people bloody mad at you, Ren.
Yeah, Ren, folks are picking sides, they sure ain't picking yours.
Then what's the point? I might as well drop it.
Sure, it looks like the odds are stacked against you right now. But my mama always says, anything that's worth fighting for. Where's my mama? Is worth fighting for!
Ren! Ah, eh! Come on!
Ren! Oh, you won't believe us!
Chuck and Ariel are gonna come back! Right! Chuck!
Oh, really? He was beside himself!
Gee, boys, come, let's go teach this kid a lesson!
Will it please stop?
Boys!
I'm going in enough trouble.
Chuck got so mad when he found out we all went to the Rebellion dance bar last night.
He ordered me not to see anymore. I told him, I see who I like. And boy, he did not like that.
Come.
I'm just so mad at myself. I don't know what I was doing with him in the first place.
Probably trying to get back to your dad. Come on.
You know what? Maybe I should talk in front of the town council.
Maybe I should.
Yeah? What are you gonna talk about, Knucklehead?
Well, actually, I would like to introduce or address the political landscape of this country and introduce them to the idea of global warming, which will inevitably kill the planet.
What? I don't understand.
Gee, stop. Stop fighting like girls.
Oh, you are girls.
The next time you do that, I'll beat you up.
But he just said,
let's go, man. I meant woman.
How much graffiti there is now?
It's not graffiti, Ren. It's called poetry. I call this place my diary.
You come up all this way just to write poems?
Yep, and they're all dedicated to my brother.
Your brother? And you never told me you have a brother.
Had a brother. Bobby. He was one of the four kids that went off the Huntley Bridge.
I bet you miss him.
Yeah. But I try not to think about it. I guess I'm like my dad in that way. I like to shut things up.
Come on now, you know that never works. I bet you think of them every single day.
How do you know that?
Because I study.
What do you see?
Someone who's smart? A little angry?
Maybe a lot angry.
Maybe a lot angry. And someone who's sad. No, I know where they come from.
Now you know.
What?
Oh, I just never really thought anyone stopped to look at me before.
Well, I do.
No, like, I just never really thought I was...
Stop. Ariel, you're constantly on my mind. Forget about everything bad in my life.
Like what?
Like this ruckus that I cooked up in Hungary. I didn't even know what I wanted to say.
Which reminds me, you're going to need this.
A Bible?
Yeah, and I've marked out all the pages that you're going to need. You'll be great.
Thank you. My name is Rin McCormick, and on the behalf of the senior class of Hanley High, I move that Local Ordinance 416, the law against dancing, be abolished.
Reverend?
Mr. McCormick, you wish to change the law because you wish to do a dance, which is your right, but it is my duty to protect this community. And in my experience, these dancers permit the use of liquor and drugs and celebrate spiritual corruption.
That's corruption! Well, excellent. I believe the case is closed.
Well, thank you, Mrs. Moore. Look. I think dancing scares a lot of people. But man, it shouldn't. From the oldest times, people used dancing for many reasons. They danced in joyful times. They danced to grieve. And Reverend, aren't we told in Psalms 149 to sing a new song unto the Lord and praise the name of dance? Ecclesiastes also states to us that there is a time to mourn and there is a time to dance. Well, Reverend, I believe it is our time to dance.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Mr. McCormack. Let's vote. No.
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 No. No.
Woo! Great. I believe council is dismissed. We meet again this time next month. Now on you go. Time you pack. Over to me to get into my chair. Oh my goodness.
Red! Until now, I have done my absolute best to keep my business in this up. But if I go say something, I'm gonna burst.
Just say it. What is it, Mom?
I'm so proud of what you did back there. Well, you didn't stand a chance. That vote was decided and stacked against you before you even walked into the room.
You think it was rigged? But Reverend Shaw's a man of God.
He's a man. And plus, you were railroaded.
Yeah, but either way, I did lose.
Your useless future was amazing. But the only thing you didn't do is something you do best. Speak from the heart.
Well, it's done now.
It's not done. Go and speak to him. Make him reconsider.
To Reverend Shaw?
Yes. And this time, just for you. Speak from here.
Reverend,
It's me, Mr. McCormack.
Look, I know, but before tonight's meeting, did you tell the council how to vote? What did you, Reverend? Look, I know what this town's been through, but banning dancing is not the answer.
Well, I assure you, you have no idea what this town has gone through. If you did, you would not have shown up there today and attempted to reopen the wounds that we have healed.
But those wounds are not healed, sir. Man, if they were, people wouldn't cross the road when I walked past it. They wouldn't ignore my mother in the supermarket. Man, this town's too scared to face the outside world. And I know that's not how Bobby would have answered
it. Don't you dare say my son's name! You did not know my son!
No, sir, I didn't. I really did wish I did. Because if he's anything like Ariel says, I believe I could have been best friends with him.
Enough of your manipulations and your nonsense! Please! I would like to be alone.
You already are alone! What don't you get? I know people come up to you too and say they get it, but they don't. Man, 100 times a day I ask myself why my dad left me. Was it because something I did? Look, I know when I came to this town it looked like I was angry and I wanted to kick up a fuss. But to be honest with you, I'm grieving too. Every now and then, I just get so hyped. I just can't stand still.
I can see.
Well, thank you for the talk.
Red, I'm sorry your father went to watch you grow up.
Dad? I thought I heard voices.
It was your friend. Rain.
Oh. What do you say?
What? I have very little to say.
Dad, I know it's hard for you. And I know I don't make it any easier. And I don't know if I believe in some of the things that you believe in. But I do believe in you, Dad. Get some rest. You have a sermon tomorrow.
If I can figure out what to say.
You will.
Troubled heart. You see, my friends, as your minister, I shall be helping you to find the joy in your lives. Last night, I realized that I haven't been doing that. After all, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago when the lives of 4 young people ended on the Huntley Bridge. Everyone in this community lost someone that night, child, a neighbor, a friend. I, Vi and I, we lost our son. Ariel lost her brother. And then, somehow it got into my head that my loss was the greatest, that my pain was the deepest. And then lost some. And then last night, someone much younger than mine made me realize just how tight I had been holding on to that memory. A memory that has weighed me down as surely as a great stone. And in that moment, I did something I haven't done in a very long time. I laid down my burden. It was a terrifying moment, and it was exhilarating. This morning, I offer you the same opportunity. The senior class of Hunley High School has asked permission to hold a dance. Great. I think that might be a good idea. Please join me in asking our Lord to guide and protect our children.
Ask my dad for a suit, and I could put a sheet at the back of his trunk so he won't get dirty. And I could make a croissant for you from the back of my mom's garden.
Well, do you mean a corsage?
Yeah, that one, croissant.
Does this mean at the dance? You're gonna dance?
Then tell Reverend Moore, but my mom, she's been teaching me how to dance every Sunday after church. I'm basically like a pro now.
So you did such a good thing today. I'm so proud of you.
I hope it was the right thing to do, but
I know it was. There was so much joy in the church today. I've missed it. I missed us. We're almost dancing.
New Zealand's first ever female
prime minister. Watch out, bro.
Thank you.
goes back to God, for without him, none of this would have been possible. And thank you guys for coming out tonight. Family, friends, students, thanks for coming to show your support. It's not every day that you see such a diverse cast share the stage. So now that you've seen the talent and the gifts of all these students, what you didn't see is the amount of hard work and the people that it took to get us up on the stage. So we'd like to call upon a few of our teachers that have helped us get to where we are. So Ms. Wyszynewski, where are you? She choreographed all of our numbers here tonight. Also Ms. Sullivan. She made some of our dresses, don't worry. Wesley Cooper, our backstage manager. We have Ms. Boffa, who's sitting in our band. Stay, please. Stay up. And also our Mr. Stanbridge from St. Paul's. Come on, on the stage. Now these three women, they've worked on this Footloose project for the past 3 years, since 2019. Can we have Ms. Smithrow, please, our director? Ms. Smithrow isn't teaching this year, she's at uni, but she's made time for us. And she's written all of our scripts tonight. Thank you, Ms. Smithrow. We also have our amazing music conductor here, Ms. Moller. Ms. Moller is the head of arts here at AGS, and she's helped a lot of us with everything. Now this woman. This woman, she doesn't take no for an answer. She's the perfectionist. She's pretty much the backbone of this show. She spent countless hours, sacrificed the past Saturdays op shopping for us. This lady, she keeps us all in check. It's our producer, Ms. Harridge. Thank you. Take these gifts as a token of our appreciation for all you all. Thank you guys for coming out.